Why is some Gurbani Panktiyan say one thing and some other Gurbani Panktiyan seem to contradict that? But there's no contradiction in Gurbani.
We just go through this very quickly.
So as this example says, Vartaman Karam is karams that we do at this time. Pralabdh Karam are the karams that we are supposed, we have written on our forehead. Gurbani Jitna Likhya, Jin Mastak Tor Har Likhya, Mastak Te, all the karams are written on the forehead that we are supposed to do in this life. Those are Pralabdh Karam. So say one of the karam could be that, or the result could be that X at the XYZ person is going to be born a very poor person. And when this person hits the age of 10, this person will probably get into an accident and lose an arm. As an example, istra karam likhe hunde ne, we as like we are given situations, they inu as situations pa dena. We can put this jeevatma in this situation that he's going to get into an accident at age 10 and he's going to lose an arm. Inu kende pralabdh, and such karam jehdi pralabdh hundi hai na, pralabdh karam, it cannot be avoided. It unu ho ke rehndi hai, inu kadi avoid nahi kar sakde. Je likhya hua na ki ye bandh tutni hai, te normally bandh tutni hai fir unu avoid nahi kar. Haan aini gal ki us jadon bandh apni tut gayi, when our arm is broken, how we react in that situation, that will shape our future karma. And then finally we have Sanchit Karam. Sanchit Karam is the other 4500 karam that are sitting in the bank account. Now I'm very quickly going to jump to next slide so that we can understand how this works. Is there a contradiction in Gurbani? On one hand, Gurbani says, Lekh na mitai hai sakhi jo likhya kartar. It means that, oh my friend, the karam of the lake that we have, they cannot be eliminated. In other words, we have to suffer the consequences. Lekh na mitai hai sakhi. Lekh means karam. That we have that written on the forehead cannot be eliminated. We have to suffer the consequence. On the other hand, Gurbani says, Gurka Shabd Kate Kot Karam. Meaning that Gurda Shabd, Jira Gurda Naam Ya, Naam Japi Hai, it can cut through millions of karams. So from the outward it seems like there's a contradiction, but it's not a contradiction. What happens is the first hukam, Lekhna Mite He Sakhi Jo Likhya Kartar, it applies to Pralabdh Karam. The karam that we are supposed to do in this life are called Pralabdh Karam. Those karams cannot be eliminated. We have to suffer those. And I want to very quickly go through a famous Sakhi from Guru Arjan Dev Ji's time. There was a king of Mandi. Mandi is a kingdom in Himachal Pradesh. King of Mandi heard about greatness of Guru Arjan Dev Ji and came for darshan. Came to Guru Arjan Dev Ji and did satsanga there. He came with all his raniya and everything. And he came for and did sangat, and he was very impressed with Guru Sahib, and finally he became a Sikh of Guru Sahib. And then while he was doing sangat, one day he heard this bani, Lekh na mitai hai sakhi jo likhya kartar. He heard this bani and he was actually upset after he heard this pankti. He said, the pankti says that no matter what you do, the lekh that you have cannot be eliminated. You have to suffer the consequences. Ye pehlo kite ne. So he was very upset. And he went up to, after the Diwan, he went to Guru Sahib. Guru Sahib ki benti ki, Sache Pasha, if the lake is never going to get eliminated, then what is the point of coming to your Sharan? What is the point of me becoming a Sikh? If jo hona ho ke rehna hai, if there's nothing, koi fayda nahi, why should I become a Sikh? Sikh banda mainu ki fayda hai. So Guru Sahib ne odo sun ke, Guru Sahib smiled. And Guru Sahib said, at this time, we'll answer your question at some other time. We'll answer the question at some other time. And Ovi Guru Sahib Raza Manli, Hukam Manli, Guru Sahib, he said, Sat Sat Bachan Sache Bachan. And it's written in our history that the same night, when he asked the question, the same night, he had a dream. In his dream, he died. The king died. He died and he had a rebirth. And that rebirth he had in the house of Chandals. Chandal, then, according to the Hindu caste system, Chandal caste is the lowest of the lowest. Unna Chandal, when they are very poor, unna janam ho gaya Chandal de kare. And in that janam, he witnessed that he saw himself taking birth in that family. Then he grew up in that family. And finally, he hit his age of marriage and he got married. he went through many, many difficulties, countless difficulties through that dream. He was greatly agitated through the dream. And then he got married, he had children, he had new problems, and finally he got old and he died. And then he woke up, and the king woke up after that, and he was very upset, but he just kept everything to himself. And the next morning, Guru Sahib told him, "Aao apna bahar sair karke aaiye, bahar let's go out." So Guru Sahib and all the other Sikhs, they went out. When they went out, the king was visibly upset. It seemed to him as if everything that had happened to him was real. He was visibly upset with the dream. And he got really upset when he reached a certain place. Don't know where that place is in Punjab now, but he reached a Pindar village where he recognized the village. That this village is the village from his dream. And then finally he even recognized, he saw some people coming, and when they came near him, he recognized that they were his children and they were his relatives. And now the king was really scared, and he's more surprised and scared when he saw that those relatives that he had seen in dream, they came running to him. And he said, "Oh, Sada Bapu da jinda hai," but he's wearing new clothes. And the king was, no, I'm Matara Bapu niga. And they started fighting, "Tu Sada Bapu, tu sanu chhad ke chala gaya." So then Guru Arjan Dev Ji, which interfered kita unhane, he said that, "Nahi, tusi ja ke check karo, jithe tusi unu dabya siga, jithe chandal unu body dab dende siga. So go and check where you buried the body, you'll find his body there." So when they actually went there, they did saw the body of their old man who had died. So then Guru Arjan Sahib Ji ne unu jawab ditta. Unu kehan lage vi jadon tusi guru ghar cha gaye, tusi guru ghar cho ke naam le liya. So guru kole eh power hai giya. This is true that lake cannot be illuminated. It cannot be illuminated, but it can be reduced. It can be reduced to such a level that it doesn't even feel. Enna vadda janam. Imagine the whole janam that he had. Sara janam finne Guru Sahib ne through dream lagata. So sara vadda vadda karam, enne vadde karma de katte gaye. So I have minu pura yakeen hai. I have full faith that whenever something so-called bad happens to Gursikhs, it always happens with a much, much reduced effect. Kade bhi Gursikhaan ho, jede Amritdhari Singh naam japde ne, paath karde ne, Guru Sahib de pyare ne, those Gursikhs never get the full effect of the past karma. Because as they said, lekhna mitai hai sakhi jo lakhya kartar, saza deri ya reward milna hai, it has to come because this is hukam, that this has to go through this janam. Oh janam, reward ya punishment milni hai. But it comes with a much reduced effect.